Lucy, Dent, and Rachel.
I believe badgers.
Yep.
Why?
Well, when I was six, I was obsessed with badgers. I just didn't think about anything else about than other than badgers. Someone said to me when I was... when they asked me, age 31 or whatever, oh, what would your specialist subject be? I was like, badgers, of course. But I hadn't thought about badgers for... what's 31 minus... that many years?
25.
and he's been drinking.
Of course, Susie Dent. Counting down.
well, there is one thing that Rachel and I do, and I blame Rachel entirely. She introduced me to this website.
Oh.
It's basically, you know, we love cats, and we quite like men. So it's poses of men and cats. And I bought you, the calendar, actually, Rachel.
Oh.
Let's just show you here. This is the cat. Can I show you? Ooh, there you go.
Wow.
It's just, what, so half, it's half a sexy man.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's got something for everyone.
Arm, that's the best one. Stay on that one. Hold up. <Darcy. laughs> Stuff. I'm loving it. Oh.
Do they never make the men?
Vow. Is it in the dictionary?
It's not there. I wish.
Points to you.
Well, artful, that was the other. I don't know if you know this about me, Jimmy, but I'm actually quite a bit awkward talking about sex. I've always been like this. When I was a teenager, I think the closest I came to having sex was when I was doing lengths in the local pool and a man butterflied over me. But I lost my virginity very late in the end, to the point where when it finally happened, I wasn't so much deflowered as deadheaded. I think part of it is because I'm British. I think it's because, you know, we're not very good at talking about sex. Not like the Americans. Like, Reg, look at the sporting analogy that you guys use. You've got the American basing analogy for sex, but when I look at that...
The Fury.
The four... who's just said, I'm a little bit British and prude.
I don't think the British could deal with that system. I think that's a bit too full on for us. I think if we had to I think if we had to have a sporting analogy for sex, it'd probably be the British cross country running system. It starts with meat in the kitchen. At
with can we have intro, Susan?
You can have intro.
I got
two sevens. You could have got
oh.
In
like a
and routine.
Man.
My two favourite things in life are real ale and medieval art. I'm basically a beardy weirdy trapped in the face of a young Mary Berry. So I'll tell you what I love about medieval art. I specifically love medieval manuscripts, which is why being in Dictionary Corner is the best place in the world for me. And I'll tell you why I love them. Because there's this thing called marginalia. This is honestly true, I'm not making it up. And basically, it's what happened in the margins in these really famous old books. So let me give you an example. Here is a picture. Really, no reason, another monk had somewhat ruined the moment by drawing a picture.
Genuine.
This is a genuine thing. This is from 1350. This is what these monks and nuns, they were awesome. They used to sit in their libraries and sort of nunneries and monasteries doing these really important old manuscripts. And then when they got a bit bored, they'd be like, yeah, let's just draw a picture of a man. It is these nuns.
German Holly Walsh.
Was a 10-letter word.
What was the 10-letter word?
Abstainers. They could have got an 8. Well, Gadishas. Gadishas.
Half of America.
Like... Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Walsh, Susie Dent, and...